Today I'm reading Ada Twist Scientist. She learned how to climb and made her big break with a trail of trolls left in her wake. She ran through the day chasing each sound and sight and didn't slow down till she come out on a Her parents were fragile, but tried not to freak. As Ada grew bigger and still did not speak clearly, young Ada was lost in her head, would have something to say when it's all done to be said. When Ada turned three, she stole through the house on a fat, spacey body spread and climbing up the clock just as high as she could. Her parents yelled, "Stop," as all good parents would. Ada chimed, but she did not cry. She took a deep breath and she simply asked why. Once again, she drifts to sleep as her dad's parents smile at the current thought of their current child who wanted to know what the world it was about. They kiss her and whisper, "You figure it out." Busy that first day of spring, testing the sound that made mockingbirds sing. Scratch whacked her right on the nose. A plunt aroma that curled up her toes. Wowzy, said Ada. Which got her thinking. What is the source of terrible thinking? How does a nose know there's something to smell? And how does it think if there's no nose to tell? She rattled off her questions and tapped on her chin. She started at the start, where she or want to begin. A mystery, a riddle, a puzzle, a quest. This was the moment that Ada loved the best. Oh, that's it. Ada did research to learn all she could with smiling and smells, both the good and good. One prophetess Ada thought could be true. The terrible stink came from that cabbage thing. She tasted, but soon Ada knew it was time to come up with the hypothesis too. Then Zoe the stink up again. Just like that. Hypothesis 2 is called by the cat. The cat would not set a stink on its own. It needs perfume and something fancy cologne. So young Ada taste the test with a flop. She started again, but her parents yelled, "Stop!" How many pages? Y'all can see they mad the parents had it. Add a mark to thinking chair now. By the time we count to three, enough, said her mother. That's it. She said her dad. Her parents were frustrated, fatwood, and mad. Why? Adam asked her. Her mother said, "No." What? Adam called her father said, "Go. You ruined a super. You'll make a cat stay enough if you push it. It's now it's sitting there and think." She looked at her parents' hard time to go. Poor Adam twist didn't know what to do. She sat all alone by herself in the hall, and Ada once more could say nothing at all. And so Ada sat, and she sat, and she sat, and she thought about science and still will and the cat, and how it, her experiment made such a big mess. Does it have to be so? Is the part of success? Are messes a problem? And why, she was thinking. What was the source of the terrible stink? Ada, Mary did what scientists do. She asked a small question, and then she asked two. And each of those led her to three questions more. And some of those questions resulted more. As Ada got thinking, she really dug in. She scribbled her question and tapped on her chin. She started at what and then what, how and when. At the end of the hall, she reached white once again. Y'all can see the drawing. Y'all can see she was already coming out. Her parents calmed down and they came back to talk. They looked at the hallway they just had to go. No patch of bare paint could be seen on the wall. The thinking chair is now as the great thick hallway. They watched their young daughter and saw it as they did. What would they do it with a serious kid who wanted to know what the world is about? They smiled and whispered, well, it